Hello everyone, this is Jude Lenard from Department of Physics, St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science, Cuddalore. Today we are going to discuss about transistor configurations. There are three types of transistor configurations: common base, common collector and common emitter configurations. This is the comparison table of these three configurations. While common collector configuration is also called as emitter follower, and comparatively common emitter configuration has wide applications. So when comparing to the other two, so we are going for common emitter configuration. Before that, we have to know what is the purpose of using these type of transistor configurations. The important thing is the amplification factor. What is amplification? It is the strengthening signals. The process of increasing the strength of a weak signal is called as amplification. And preferring common emitter configuration over the other two. Why? Why it is so? Why we prefer common emitter configuration over common base and common collector? The important point to note is, in common emitter configuration, the maximum voltage and current gain, it provides the maximum voltage and current gain, whereas the other two either has provide high current gain or voltage gain, but it is the common emitter configuration to provide both the voltage and current gain. Let me see the working of common emitter amplifier. So here BJT, bipolar junction transistor, is used for this amplifier. As the name insists, it has both, it is emitter as common to both input and output signal. It is similar arrangement for both PNP as well as NPN transistor. Only they differs in the biasing. Now, when the input signal is applied across the emitter base junction, what happens is it gets forward bias across the junction. As a result, there is an increase during the upper half cycle. This leads to increase in the flow of electrons from the emitter to the collector through the base. As a result, there is an increase in collector current. This increasing collector current makes more voltage drop across the collector load resistor RC. The negative off cycle decreases the forward bias voltage across the emitter base junction. The decreasing collector base voltage also decreases the collector current in the total collector resistor RC. Thus, the amplification appears across the collector resistor. The important thing to note is the emitter common emitter amplifier circuit has 180 degree phase shift between the input and the output waveforms. This graph shows the input characteristics of common emitter configuration, where an input current, IB, base current, is a function of an input voltage given between a base and emitter for various output voltage between collector and emitter. This shows the output characteristics of a common emitter configuration, and there are three types of modes represented in the output characteristics. This graph reveals about the output characteristics, and the magnitude of base current IB is in microampere and not as horizontal as I emitter current in the common base circuit. It is a comparative thing. And the next thing is, the output set relates an output current IC to the specific output voltage VCE, and this can be done for various levels of input current IB. there are three major regions in the output characteristics. The first one is active region. You can see in the active region, in the topmost right quadrant, has a linearity in nature. There is not much difference in the curves, and the curve of base current IB are almost straight. They are equally spaced. There is not much difference in the space, and this can be employed for voltage, current, as well as power amplification. The next one is cutoff region. As you know, the region below where no base current flows, and it is defined as the cutoff region. And this region should be avoided for linear amplification. And the next region is saturation region. The region you can see in the graph, it is shaded over there in the graph. The region near the ordinate is the saturation region. And the beta value ranges from 50 to 400. These are the very simple and known advantages of common input amplifier. It has low input, high output impedances, and high voltage and current gain. And there are disadvantages too. It responds very poor to the high frequencies, and it has the high thermal instabilities. And the applications of common emitter amplifier is, it is well suited for voltage amplification, and especially at very low frequencies. And as we already know that it doesn't work for high frequencies, and it well suited for voltage amplification at very low frequencies. And it is commonly used in radio frequency circuits and low noise amplifiers. These are the basic ideas of common emitter configuration, and it gives some idea about it. Thank you for listening.